In this video, I'll show you how to get from zero C++ experience to making games from scratch in C++ with a 3-step framework. When I was around 13 years old, I started learning C++, and even though I was practicing almost every day, it took me years to make my first game. Now that I made this YouTube channel, however, I meet many people that managed to start with no experience and make a C++ game in only a few months. From spending years to only a few months, there is clearly a right and a wrong way of doing things. So listen carefully, because I will tell you the exact pitfalls to watch out for. The first step is to learn the language, and there are many tutorials online, and even paid ones. Here is the thing, they are all the same. Trust me, they are all the same thing. There is no point in paying for a beginner's course. You'll have the exact same information in any YouTube tutorial. So, just start with any tutorial. I'll link one down below, but watch it after this video. There are still many pitfalls. And by the way, there are many coding editors that you can use, but for game development with C++ in Windows, I recommend Visual Studio if your computer isn't very slow. Now, once you learn some basic things about the language, you'll probably be tempted to learn as much as possible about it. So step 2 is to actually slow down your C++ learning once you know some basics and start making some very simple projects. So that doesn't mean stop learning, it means learn a little bit, but spend most of your time with tutorials closed and try to make a simple project out of your head. So watching C++ tutorials is not at all the same thing as learning to code is. You are just learning to use the language, but coding means solving difficult tasks that take many lines of code and have very complex behaviors. And you can only learn that by doing. Make a simple program that can draw shapes on the console, for example, and get some help from Stack Overflow or ChatGPT whenever you don't know how to do something. If you need some inspiration, you can also subscribe to my channel, because I only do C++ game dev related content here. Here is the thing, with only the basic things that you can learn in 2 days, you can basically make a game or pretty much anything. And not only that, but a lot of advanced things like polymorphism, private variables, OOP, functional programming, or exceptions, I honestly think will make you write worse code, and I never use them. And especially as a beginner, you can't really know what is good for you and what is bad, and it is really easy for someone to tell you to write code in this way because it is better, when it really isn't. So, I say, ignore all advice that tells you to write code in a specific way, and OOP and whatever. My advice is to write code very simply, without too much abstractions. And the reason I say this is the better way is because once you write the code simply, you can see better the direction in which the project is going, and you can easily modify some parts if needed in a better direction. And that new direction could even be some OOP or functional programming. Or most of the time, it is perfectly to keep the code simple as it is. But think about it. If someone tells you that you have to always write code in a certain way, that can't be good 100% of times. Every problem has a different solution. So, try to do things your own way, and you might be able to discover a better solution. And you will need to also learn about algorithms and data structures. And there are some people online that say that they are very important. In fact, they are the thing that you will study most in university. But look, see this Minecraft clone I made? The only algorithms and data structures I used for it are the absolute most basic ones that you usually already learn in intermediate C++ tutorials. So, for now at least, don't spend all your day learning algorithms. You should know that some things like sorting and graphs exist, and what they are, but you can learn a little more about them once you need them. Now we get into the third step, and that is to start making your game. So, in step 1, you learn the language, and in step 2, you learn to code. Now you are actually ready to make a simple game. And again, notice that I want you to take action and write code, not just spend time learning. In the beginning, I strongly recommend searching for one lone coder on YouTube, because this guy has very simple tutorials for game development, and the very old ones are done directly in the console. But after that, you'll want to learn how to make a proper game. And there are many tutorials and channels on this topic, where you can learn just that, and I'll recommend you one of them in just a second. The difficult part, however, is linking libraries. You see, in order to make a game in C++, you need a drawing library. This is basically some code written by someone else that you can use to easily draw things on the screen. And there are many choices, like SFML and Rylib, but you need to integrate that library in your C++ project, and the process is hard and annoying. Luckily, most tutorials show you how to do that part, but there are still many potential problems. So, to solve all of them, I made templates for game development with various libraries that you might want to use, that will also work for you. So, if you want to use any of these libraries that I show here, also go watch this video for details. So, I can recommend you, for example, to start this tutorial using the SFML library. It is very well made, and there are also other tutorials on YouTube with SFML. Just take the SFML template from the video I just showed you earlier and start making the game. Or, if you want to learn from me, I also have a 30-minute full game tutorial. Wait here, I have a last secret for the few of you that watched the whole video. If you want to succeed, you need to take action as soon as possible, even if you only have a few minutes. Go now in the description, and depending on your current level, choose the video that suits you best so you finally level up. And also join my Discord if you want to share some progress pictures. See you!